Hello and welcome to Swaggy Amma, and today we are back with another interesting recipe from the Maharashtrian cuisine. We'll be seeing how to make a famous street food variety, vada pav, at home. Firstly, to prepare the dry chutney, few of the ingredients which we require would be 1/4 cup of grated coconut, 1/4 cup of groundnut, 2 to 3 Kashmiri dried red chilli, 4 to 5 garlic pod, salt as per taste. Next, to prepare the stuffing for the patata vada, the ingredients that we require would be 2 medium sized potato, 1 inch ginger finely chopped, same amount of garlic, 2 to 3 green chilli finely chopped, 1 teaspoon of mustard, few curry leaves for tempering, 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1/4 teaspoon of coriander powder, 1/4 teaspoon of chaat masala, 1 teaspoon of Kashmiri dried red chilli, and salt as per taste. To prepare the batter for the batata vada, 1 cup of besan or gram flour, 1/2 teaspoon of Kashmiri dried red chilli powder, 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1/4 teaspoon of asafoetida powder, and salt as per taste. Begin by peeling the outer skin of the potato with the help of a peeler. Later chop them into medium sized cubes. Transfer the chopped potato into a pressure cooker and add 1/2 cup of water into it. Now close this with a lid and pressure cook this for minimum 2 to 3 whistle in medium to high flame. Next, take a mixing bowl and into that add the besan or gram flour, salt, asafoetida powder, turmeric powder, Kashmiri dried red chilli powder, and mix all the dry ingredients well. Next, into this add water little by little and mix the batter well. Make sure there are no lumps formed in it. And here I have taken about 3/4 cup of water, and make sure the batter is not too watery and is of the right consistency as shown in the video. Once you have prepared the batter, allow this to rest for some time before further use. In the meantime, take a thick bottom kadai or a pan, and once the kadai is hot enough, transfer the garlic pod and the groundnuts into it. Saute this and cook in low to medium flame for another 2 to 3 minutes. After 2 to 3 minutes, add the freshly grated coconut and the Kashmiri dried red chilli into it. Saute and cook all the ingredients in low to medium flame until they are dry roasted well and the grated coconut turns golden brown. Once all the ingredients are dry roasted well, allow this to cool down at room temperature for some time. In the meantime, take a mixer jar and into that add the finely chopped ginger, garlic and green chilli and grind this coarsely. Finally, to prepare the dry chutney, take a grinder jar and transfer the dry roasted ingredients into it. Now grind this coarsely and into this add salt as per taste and grind this once again. Now your delicious dry chutney is ready. This can be used immediately, or you can even store this in an airtight container and freeze this or refrigerate this and use maximum for 15 days. Next, to prepare the stuffing for the batata vada, take a thick bottom kadai or a pan and into that add 2 to 3 tablespoons of sunflower oil. Once the oil is hot enough, add 1 teaspoon of mustard seed and few curry leaf and prepare the tempering. Once the tempering is prepared, add the previously prepared ginger, garlic and green chilli paste and saute this and cook until they turn aromatic or golden brown. Now into this, add the previously pressure cooked potato and saute this for about a minute. Later mash them well with the help of a masher. Once the potatoes are mashed well, into this add 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1/4 teaspoon of coriander powder, salt as per taste, 1/4 teaspoon of chaat masala and 1 teaspoon of dry red chili powder. Mix this well and now saute this and cook for another 2 to 3 minutes in low to medium flame. Now your delicious stuffing is ready. Now allow this to cool down for some time before further use. Take small portion of the prepared stuffing and roll them into medium sized balls. Next, take the previously prepared batter and give it a good mix. Now dip the stuffing into it and make sure the batter is uniformly coated on all the sides. For deep frying, take a kadai with oil enough for deep frying and once the oil is hot enough, turn the flame to medium. Now transfer the vadas into it and deep fry them in medium flame until they turn crisp and golden brown. Once all your batata vada are deep fried in batches, switch off the flame and in the same oil deep fry some green chili until they turn crisp. Now our delicious batata vada is ready. We can see how crisp and well cooked they are. Next, to prepare the vada pav, we have bought some store-bought pav or buns. Gently slit the pav or bun from the center as shown in the video. Now garnish them generously with the previously prepared dry chutney. Now press the batata vada gently and place them between the pav or the bun. Garnish generously with some more dry chutney and now your delicious vada pav is ready. This can be had as an evening snack or during any time of the day. So do try this recipe at home and do let me know on how it was in the comment section. If you like this video, do not forget to give us a thumbs up and to share it along with your friends. Thank you for watching and do not forget to like, follow and subscribe to Swaggy Amma in Facebook, Instagram and YouTube.